Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Microsoft Flight Simulator. And today we are back in action, starting out with the Zivco Edge 540 version 2 from the LivToAir developer. This aircraft is absolutely amazing, you guys, and wait till you see everything that comes with it at an extremely reasonable price. Stick around. If you are interested in acquiring any of my Overkill's tutorial guides for Microsoft Flight Simulator, or simply interested in supporting the channel, please consider joining us on Patreon. Patreon subscribers level tier 2 and above have access to all of my guides, as well as any future releases that come down the road. Patreon link can be found in the description below. Alright, so you guys, first off, sorry for the hiatus and the disappearance here over the last week or so and the delay in videos. December has been quite the wild ride, as I'm sure for many of you as well, but it has definitely had some unexpected twists and turns and definitely pulled me away from the simulation more times than expected, to say the least. But today, as I said, we are back with the amazing LivToAir Zivco Edge 540 version 2. And this aircraft comes at an absolutely stunning price of $14.49 US. A link to the purchase will be down in the description below. Now, I have done as far as starting the engines up, you guys, took it for a quick spin and landed it just to sort of get an idea of what I'm in for. And I can tell you right now, this aircraft boasts a lot. So first off, with the purchase, what do you get? You get three different variants of the aircraft. You have a regular with absolutely no winglets that is designed for aerobatics. You have a small winglet version, which is used for aerobatics and racing. And then we have the large winglet version, which we're using today, which is designed specifically for air racing. We're actually going to try an air race track here, and we're going to be using the Pimax Crystal once we jump into the cockpit to run all of our testing here. So it's going to be pretty awesome. There's eight liveries for each aircraft. As you can see today, we're sporting America for our flight today and our air race, if you will. Because, you know, if I'm going to embarrass somebody, I might as well embarrass my own country here, because I guarantee this is going to be a rough ride. We have working circuit breakers, prop strike animation, and that's actually one of those things that you have to be very careful of, and we'll talk about that when we get into the aircraft here. I am flying from the desk today, you guys, so I don't have my rudder pedals in front of me, so all of my action is going to be based on twist grip and a button press for the wheel brake. So you guys are going to see me tipping the aircraft nose pretty forward pretty often, so we'll talk about that. There is a canopy ejection animation. We're not going to be showing that out today, but I can tell you that it does work, as I found that out the hard way. There are two cockpit configurations for racing and aerobatics used via basically a smartphone screen that you guys will see in just a minute. And then the best aerobatic flight model for the sim is what it is boasting, and I will absolutely agree with that. Now, one of the other cool things is that there is a smoke effect with multiplayer support. What that means, you guys, is that a lot of the aircraft that generate smoke, you actually can't see it in multiplayer, where this one, you can. It's a code that has to be specifically written for multiplayer. And then again, we talked about there is a phone electronic flight bag. I don't know if I would call it the EFB, but it's definitely there. Now, we're going to talk about some of the things that I like and dislike about the aircraft right out of the gate once we jump into the cockpit. The overall texturing, guys, is very, very well done, although there are some parts that I'm going to let you guys decide that are flat, could probably use a bit of touch-up and sharpening. There's some pixelization that I can pick out, but again, I'm not going to be directly pointing those out. If you guys don't see it, you don't see it. If you do, you do. However, one of the things that I am going to talk about real quick is that the aircraft performs very, very well in virtual reality. And that's why I decided that my first flight with you guys was going to be in VR and doing a race, because that is the critical nature. And there's going to be nothing better than doing a racing simulation like this, an air race in VR. With VR, you get the depth perception, sense of speed, motion, all that good jazz. So you get a much greater effect than you would in an immersion experience than you would in 2D. And of course, that's always going to be preference, guys, but that is my overall standing on virtual reality. I think virtual reality's greatest shining points is, in fact, with flight simulation. And again, we're going to be using the Pimax Crystal, you guys. It is an absolutely stellar headset. It is currently on sale if you guys want to check that out. You can also save a few extra bucks by using my link down in the description below. And yes, it absolutely helps me out here as well as I get a little kickback. I don't hide any of that, but just a real quick touch on Pimax, guys. I have been an avid Pimax user since their first release. I have owned and purchased every single release they've ever put out. The Pimax Crystal was the first one that I've owned that was provided to me by Pimax themselves. Everything else I have purchased myself. So yes, I am a Pimax fanboy, and they continued that with the Crystal. We're also going to be doing a comparison between the 8KX and the Crystal coming up here this week that I think you guys will find very interesting in. If you are already an 8KX user, you might decide whether or not you might help you decide whether or not you want to upgrade. Anyways, enough sales pitch. So getting into the aircraft, you guys, this is my first complaint. The camera angle is very odd. It looks very squished to me. It looks very stretched. It looks very odd right up into the clouds and everything in the surrounding area. It looks very odd. However, if you take your camera view and you push it forward, it's not near as bad, but you can still sort of see it has sort of a squished feel. So I don't know what that is. I don't know enough about graphic design to be able to point that out. And I don't want to judge too harshly because, again, I am not a developer. I certainly don't know anything about this. So I don't want to speak too harshly here. And again, I will tell you right now that the aircraft is still very perfectly priced for what you get. But even if you look up here at the moon, you guys, it looks kind of stretched and wobbly. So there's definitely something weird happening with the camera view in this particular aircraft. Even if you try messing with the zoom, I don't notice a whole lot of improvement with that. So I'm not sure what's causing that. Now, on the contrast to that, I don't notice it in virtual reality. So that is a cool part too. If you're an avid VR flyer, I don't have any issues with that in VR. Now, real quick, something that has been coming up on some of these reviews that I do want to show you guys is a lot of people ask, what are your video settings? Okay, so you can see right now, you guys, we are currently running 2560 by 1440. Now, this is the monitor resolution. Let's go ahead and switch over to VR because that's what you guys are going to be seeing. VR, again, here you guys can see what all of the current settings are. Now, you know what? I'm actually going to crank that up. I don't know why that was down so low. That should not have been down that low. And then the other thing we're going to do is actually switch over into DLSS. We're going to go DLSS and we're going to go quality and keep it there. As far as, see, there's actually a lot of things that are very, it's almost like all of my settings have been reset. This is actually kind of odd. I'm not quite sure what happened here. What is this? All right, let's go high end. There we go. That's a little bit better. Let's start there. So you guys actually will get a little bit more than what I anticipated out of this video because I just changed all of my graphic settings. So if we have any weird issues, you guys will get to see that. Reprojection mode, let's use depth, hit apply. All right, and now let's get back into the cockpit. Did that change anything for us? I don't think it did. I think we're still seeing the same, yeah, still same behavior. Now, here is the EFB that we talked about. And you guys can see it sort of in the zoom too, or when I rotate the camera. Everything gets a little beer bottle-y, if you were. Yes, I said beer bottle, leave me alone. I don't even drink, which is what's funny about that. Anyway, there's not anymore. Now, the cockpit configuration. You can see it's certainly currently set to aerobatics. We're going to change that to racing, and now you get a... it's a G meter, but I can't remember what the actual word is, guys. It's right on the tip of my tongue. It's not called a G meter. Something speed. Anyway, I can't think of it right now. Parking brake. This is how you activate and deactivate the parking brake is from here. I haven't found a way to bind it. I have my parking brake bound to my controls using spad.next, and it doesn't seem to work in this aircraft. So that is something else to be thinking about, is it looks like at the moment, at least, you do have to use the parking brake button here on the EFB. And again, I use the term EFB because they have it, but these are the only two functions that are currently inside the phone there. Gosh, that is going to drive me nuts. Accelerometer. That's what that's called. Accelerometer. Anyway, and you guys can see it there as well. There, I got it. It had nothing to do with speed. Okay. So now that we have that all set up, let's go ahead and just start getting the aircraft ready to roll here. So I'm going to start out by switching this over into VR and, we'll get the aircraft out of here. Okay. So now that I've made some of those, graphical changes, things are actually gotten a little bit smoother than what I was expecting, which is good. Let's see here. My IPD is messed up. So that was my fault. I was playing with buttons I should not have been playing with. Okay, so we were talking earlier about the bottle effect, right? So I do not see that, or fisheye, I guess, is the best way to describe it. I don't see that in VR, but I am going to scoot myself up. I do think the default view is a little too far back just for comfort purposes. But let's go ahead and get the aircraft up and running here. So we're going to start with our master battery. fuel tank selection. I'm going to start with the right wing. You guys are going to hear my voice sort of fade in now as I look away from the microphone. I'm going to go ahead and turn that fuel pump on. I don't think there's any lights or anything like that that I have to worry about with this particular aircraft. So we're just going to go ahead and let's see here. Let's set our axis. We got mixture to full rich. Propeller. Crack the throttle, just like always. And let's let it rip. And there she is, alive and ready to roll. Beautiful. So I'm getting a nice solid 40 frames right now, okay? And again, I don't notice any issues when we get up and moving. I thought I saw a plane up there. That caught my attention. All right, let's turn our avionics master on. Shouldn't need the fuel pump anymore. I'm gonna shut that off. Great engine control panel here. Let's set that barometric pressure. Looks like we're already at sea level, obviously. Come on, Garmin. Waiting for the old 530 or 430 to start up here. Come on, baby. Let's go. There we go. All right, not that I ever use it, but what the hell? We'll start it, right? Okay, so now we're just gonna release that parking brake. Whoa. Now here's what I'm talking about. Looks like we actually want to come down this way based on the wind, although this thing grips it and rips it. I'll tell you that right now. You can take off very, very quickly with this aircraft. The propeller does have a little bit of an odd effect in virtual reality. I'm not going to hide that from you guys. I don't know if that's displaying correctly on the screen, but there is sort of a shimmer, glimmer, twist, and turn that, you know, kind of happens with it. I am actually, like, sticking out of the canopy, which is really even weirder. Can't see the end of this runway. I'm trying to do S-turns here, but they're making me nervous because I'm so close. All right, so here's what I'm talking about, and there is prop strike, so... And this began because I'm using a button for my brake axis instead of my rudder pedals, because we're not in the cockpit today. All right, you ready for this? This thing just goes, dude. So we're gonna try to slowly accelerate. We don't have a lot of runway. She goes, and we are already at takeoff speed. So, one of the things that were done very, very beautifully about this aircraft is I can make nice, gentle turns. Very limited input on the stick. Or, we can snap this thing around like you would not believe. It gets absolutely crazy in this thing. There's our racetrack, you guys. And I am petrified of this one. But let's go ahead and see how terrible I am. All right, guys, wish me luck. Here we go. This should tell you guys everything you need to know about this aircraft. Just don't judge the pilot. I'm gonna start out a little slower than probably I could, but here we go. Coming through the first gate. All right, and cranking, turning, burning. Oof. Oh my gosh. Holy crap. Okay. Ah, no! Like I said, don't judge the pilot. Here we go. Where the hell? Oh, I know where we are. All right, up we go. Up we go. Nose down a little bit. One more time, we're gonna try this, guys. See if I can get through one. gonna pull it back this time even slower. Sensitive. That one. I'm supposed to come around this way. No, damn it. Ah. All right, let's try this one more time. Terrifying, man. I had to adjust my headset there. Oh, why is the smoke on? And I will show you guys the smoke. All right, here we go. I'm gonna go slower this time. Coming around. Totally missed the gate. I'm in the wrong spot. Yo. No, 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 no. What is happening? Oh, what was that? Oh, that was terrible. What the heck happened there? Oh, man. Okay, so clearly I'm not ready to showcase air racing because I am all over the place. So I'll tell you what, let's go grip it and rip it around the countryside here. And hopefully you guys get an idea, and then we'll bring it in and land it, because damn, I need practice. It almost looked like compressibility is what happened there, because I lost complete control of the aircraft there coming into that dive. I lost it. I had no control. So I'm thinking that I got into compressibility. I got going too fast. Let's show you guys the smoke at least. The smoke they did an absolutely great job with. Trying to go up and around it. The aircraft is so touchy, it's so powerful. You guys can see it lasts for a long time. And the aircraft is absolutely beautiful. It lasts for a long time. So again, an absolutely beautiful job done by Live2Air. I need some more experience before I even try to do air race again. The aircraft is so touchy, but I'll tell you what, I think since we're here, I'm gonna try it one more time. So far back. Come on. Come on. One. Two. Five. Ah, get down there. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down there. Get down there. Get back down there. Oh, thank gosh, those aren't collidable. Okay, and then it's... I went too far. So we're just gonna call that what it is. Oh! No, no, not again. Not again. Okay. All right, let's land this thing before I hurt myself again. sometimes you just have to bite the bullet and call it a day. I think my day has come. Okay, so let's pull power off. Thing slows down very, very nicely too. Oh, I like the bannering in the water, that's cool. All right. Pull the power off, she just dumps. Ah, let's try that again. I'm still going too fast. Way too steep. Still making that turn too tight. This thing's just so touchy. I'm trying to make a tight entry in. It's not working out well. Let's keep it lower. That's a pretty shot. Baby, come on. It's a good thing this thing stops quickly. That was another terrible approach. So it's incredibly powerful. It's incredibly fast. It's incredibly well done. Microsoft, seriously? Get off. Almost tail-striked. It definitely requires a lot. We will be doing another video probably at the end of the week of this aircraft when I've had some more time to practice with it. But I can tell you guys, it's an absolutely stellar plane. You will definitely enjoy this experience.
please don't judge it based on my flight experience. I was a terrible pilot today. The aircraft itself handles absolutely gorgeous. It just does such a good job, and I have to learn how to be faster on the controls. You know, I was starting to at least get an understanding of how to take those turns over there on the air race. You know, pulling the stick up a little bit, getting my nose a little higher angle as I go into the knife edge. But yeah, a lot more practice is definitely necessary. It's definitely something that I think would be a lot of fun to do some sort of community air race. I think that would be neat. So anyways, guys, let me know what your thoughts are about that, and maybe we can put something together. That'd be kind of fun. Make sure you guys join the Discord, guys. I would love to have you guys join. And then please, as always, if you guys enjoyed the video, consider liking, subscribing here on the channel. As always, folks, stay safe and healthy, and I'll see you in the next one.